Hi everyone, welcome to our Monday live stream. This is a very exciting live stream today as we are doing a giveaway for tickets to 5 lucky winners to the Great Grow Along event. So we had a ton of entries over on the Hardening Off video over the weekend. That was how you entered. And we're gonna do a random drawing today. Now, if you're not familiar with the Great Grow Along event, it is an amazing virtual garden festival to kick off spring. It's coming up this coming weekend. Spring is on Saturday. The Virtual Garden Festival is a 3-day event that's held online with tons of top garden influencers and plant pros will be presenting on a variety of different topics, including small space gardening, edible gardening, urban gardening, house plants. It is going to be a ton of fun. There's going to be over 40 hours of gardening content that you can watch over the weekend. And if you reserve your spot, then you can have access to that content for 6 months. So if you are a plant lover, you do not want to miss this festival. You can learn more about it at thegreatgrowalong.com. But today we are doing a giveaway for 5 tickets. So I'm super excited about that. Camera guy is here in the house. Hello. Jerry's watching from work. Cliff and Nisha are our moderators. They're going to keep us moving along today. And I'm very thankful to all of you who are here to join us on our very exciting live stream drawing. So here's how it's going to work. What I do is I do the drawing using something called the YouTube Random Comment Picker. And I just enter the URL of the video where you all entered your comments. And then it scrolls through and picks one person randomly. Now, this is an especially exciting giveaway because it was open. We opened it up to worldwide viewers, and we've never been able to do that before. As long as you have an email address, you are good to go if you win, because I just send you a code. And then you go over to the greatgrowalong.com website and grab your ticket that way. So you can watch the Great Grow Along no matter where you're at in the world. And if you don't win, make sure you head over to purchase a ticket. I think they're only around $29, so it's a very reasonable price for tons of garden content. So thank you guys all for joining me today. Let's just say hello to those of you here in the chat. And then we're going to jump in and choose our first winner. And I'm also going to be answering some questions live. And I also chose some questions from our YouTube videos over the past week that we're going to answer live here as well. The chat is scrolling by. So hello to Teresa Creamer from Florida. Hi, Teresa. How are you doing? I'm glad I got to make it today. I'm up potting my plants while watching. Perfect. I love how you are multitasking. I do that all the time, and you can get a ton of stuff done that way. Antonella, hi Kim and Jerry. Hi Antonella, how are you? Thank you so much for joining us today. Peggy LaSala is here from Florida. Linda Peer, thank you so much, Linda, for your kind words. She says, you're amazing. I've learned so much. So happy to hear that. That's great. DKB1125 from Ohio. Love that you're helping me in starting your seeds. Been so awesome watching your videos. That's great. Thank you so much. Janella M, very new Florida gardener here. Yay. Hello. So glad that you're here, Janella. I'm so happy that you are gardening for the very first time. We have a ton of new gardeners joining us this year, and it's just so much fun to grow our gardens together, share tips and tricks, and just see how everybody's doing in different zones. Stacy, snowing in Chicago. Stay warm, Stacy. Spring is just 4 days away, and hopefully that will help you just hang in there a little bit longer. And if anyone is from Denver, my parents live in Denver, and they're getting crazy amounts of snow. So hang in there, you guys. Stay safe, stay warm, and pretty soon the weather will be warming up. Let's see if we have anyone here. If we have anyone here from internationally, please say hello. Let us know where you are from. We usually have several international viewers, and it's always fun to hear about how people are growing on the other side of the world. Mountain Properties, hello. Much rain over your way. We got a really good heavy downpour this morning, and I was hoping that I'd be able to come outside to live stream. I was getting ready to set up inside, but the sun came out, things cleared up. It's a little bit chilly for us Californians anyway. It's only around 50 degrees, but it's a beautiful day, and we're out here celebrating spring with some beautiful Gerbera daisies. You guys like these? I love the bright pops of color. I grabbed these at Topanga Nursery, which is near us, yesterday. And smart pots, you guys, These are 5 gallon smart pots with cute little handles. Don't you guys love these? So I'm actually considering carrying these in my seed shop. So if you guys think I should carry these cute little 5 gallon smart pots with my logo and smart pots logo on them, let me know here in the chat. I'm going to reach out to them and see if we can't work something out. We've got the black ones and then the small little 1 gallons, but I think these are absolutely beautiful. They sent me some of these last week and I am in love with them. So a lot of people are saying yes, they would like to have those as well. So I will contact them and see what we can do. But get yourself some bright pops of color planted. I cannot even tell you guys what a lift that gave me to get these planted yesterday, to go grab some flowers, just to get some color outside. And you guys need to go over to Camera Guy's Instagram at Cali Camera Guy. He posted a picture of me picking up these flowers over at the garden center. And he posts all kinds of fun behind the scenes type of photos over there. So without further ado, let's jump into our first winner. And then we'll be sharing some tips in between choosing our winners. So what I'm going to do is turn my camera around. I've got my computer right in front of me here. And I always forget how to turn the camera around here on the live stream. No, that's comments. We don't want that. That's a filter. Where is the camera? It's usually right up top here. Oh, and shoot, now my filters are scrolling by. Gosh, why is this not? I'm looking for it. I don't know why. Oh, okay, here we go. It was down in the corner, kind of hidden. Okay, so I've got my camera right here, or not my camera, my computer right here in front of me. And how it works is, see if I can get the glare off the screen here so you guys can see. Okay, hopefully that's a little bit better. So I've got the URL entered right here in the random comment picker. And we are going to get all the YouTube comments. So if you commented on Saturday's video, you are entered in the drawing. We have 267 comments. So great job, you guys. We love reading all the comments, seeing all the participation. You guys ready for the first winner? For a ticket to the great grow along, whoops. Our first winner is, congratulations to the R&S Garden. This is awesome. She or he won the very first ticket. And the comment was, great suggestions. Gradually will harden the plants, will strengthen them. Hope my first garden will be successful. So this is so exciting. We got our very first winner. And if you are a winner, what you need to do is email me. So I can email you your code for your free ticket. And my email is callikim@callikimgardenandhome.com. So just email me, put giveaway winner in the subject line. Very important that you do that so your email doesn't get lost in my inbox. And then I will email you a code. And if you could email me as soon as possible, that would be great. But for sure by this coming Wednesday, so you can get your code and make sure that you know exactly where to go and get logged on at thegreatgrowalong.com, and it will be so exciting. And I'm going to be speaking at the Great Grow Along on, my presentation will be aired on Saturday morning at 8:45 a.m. Pacific time. That's this coming Saturday, the first day of spring. So how fun is that? And then I will be doing a live Q&A right after the presentation. So you can log on at that time, see my presentation, and participate in the live Q&A. And I'm not sure if the live Q&A will be replayed or not, but you can go back and watch my presentation at a later time as well. But I'm telling you guys, there's a ton of other presenters as too. You guys know Kevin from Epic Gardening. He's going to be presenting. Some of the other people are Hilton Carter, Summer Ray Oaks, Daryl Chang, Bree Arthur, Nick Kasumpas. He's actually a friend of ours. He's a great professional landscaper. Doug Tallamy, Timothy Hammond, Lisa Steele, and lots of others. So it's going to be a lot of fun and a great way to kick off the spring weekend. Okay, so what we're going to do now before we go in and pick another winner is I'm going to share some answers to some, I'm going to share, start off with one answer to a question that we got in our YouTube videos over the past week. And then I want to take your live questions as well and answer as many as we can in between the winners. So the first question that we had, this person is named Ramon Brown that asked this question. And Ramon said, how long after your last frost date do you usually wait to plant outside? I've heard others say not to plant tomatoes outside until the nighttime lows are in the 50s. I think this person might have meant to say the nighttime highs are in the 50s. I'm about 2 weeks past my last frost date and checking my 10-day forecast, temps are still in the 40s. Would it be okay to transplant my tomatoes in 10 days and nightly lows are still around 45? Okay, that was a great question. And I actually mentioned this in the video on Saturday that it's a good idea to wait to plant your warm weather vegetables out in the garden until your temperatures are in the 50s and 60s at nighttime. However, that's not to say that you couldn't get them out there a little bit sooner if you provide some kind of protection for them. Because if you're in a northern climate, like Cliff actually mentioned to me this morning, he's in Idaho, Cliff, our moderator, and oftentimes the temperatures are in the 40s well into like May, possibly even June. So you want to provide your warm weather crops with some type of cover to just kind of help them get through those cold nights. That way it just kind of helps them, you know, ease the time into the warm weather hits. So you can either do a really simple like plastic cover over them. You can put like a plastic storage bin over them. That will provide a little bit of protection on those cooler nights. Or I know Cliff does, wow, July is the only month I don't see 30s. That's crazy, Cliff. Cliff is the master at protecting his tomatoes. He does something called a wall of water. And it's a special cover that you put around your plants. And Cliff might be able to share a little bit more about that in the chat here. But there's all different ways that you can protect your plants. It doesn't have to be anything fancy. I've even done like a heavy quilt or something like that over my tomato cage. You know, little milk jugs over small seedlings. So if you provide them with some type of cover, it just kind of helps bridge that gap in between the cooler nights and the warmer nights. And then once things warm up in the 50s and 60s, that is the kind of temperatures that the warm weather vegetables like the best, and you will really see them take off. So yeah, search the internet if you want to purchase something, or you can go back and watch my video called DIY Easy Winter Cover, where I show you how to cover an entire garden bed with just a piece of thick plastic and some stakes. Very simple, very cheap, and super easy to do. So go back and watch that video for more details, but get creative. Just look around your house, see what you have, and get those plants out there. But I would definitely wait. Cliff, I don't know, maybe you would disagree, but I would wait until after your last frost date, unless you have a really good cover or some type of a heated greenhouse. So any input in the comments would be much appreciated. So get out there, get to planting. And I was really happy to hear a lot of you that were already hardening off your vegetables. In fact, I've got some cucumbers and squash right on my right side, and then some tomatoes on my left side that are hardening off in between the little 1 gallon tiny Tims. So it's a great time to get those things going. Okay, so I see some comments in here. Joanna Alva would totally buy the colorful smart pots with handles. Wonderful. I'm gonna go back to smart pots and let them know that you guys are wanting them. And I'm not sure if these are available yet on their website, but we will definitely be, I'll be checking with them too and letting you guys know when those are gonna be available. Okay, let's head into the chat and see what questions you have. Let's see, Irene said she's covering hers with pots, your little seedlings with pots. So yeah, that's a great idea. You can use like those nursery pots that you might have planted trees or transplants in another year. So definitely look around and recycle. Cliff Warren saying Cozy Coats is a good brand. So wonderful. That's one thing I love about this community. We're all happy to share suggestions and help each other out. Okay, let's see here. Any questions? If not, we will swing back in and pick our number two winner. Let's see here. Backyard gourds. Wish I can start more seed. I ran out of seed starting mix and the store doesn't have any. At least that's what my daughter says. She does my shopping, Patsella. My backyard gourds, that's great. The wind's starting to blow. Make your own if you can't find any at the garden center. You probably watched our seed starting mix video a few weeks ago on how to make your own. You're gonna save a lot of money because seed starting mix is super expensive as well. And you guys, if you're here for the first time and haven't started your seeds yet, go back and watch the Spring Garden series from the very beginning. It'll answer a ton of questions for you. There's videos on there, even from last year, the Spring Garden playlist, Spring Garden series playlist about transplanting, about grow lights, about getting your vegetable garden bed prepared, installing drip irrigation, all kinds of information out there. And if you haven't yet planted your seeds or have seeds, please grab my Spring Garden Seed Collection, 13 varieties in here that are gonna help you get started in no time. And then my Organic Gardening for Everyone book. They really go together along with our Spring Garden series. You have everything written down. And you'll save $5 when you purchase them as the bundle, as opposed to picking them up separately at CallieKimGardenHome.com. So a great value. These are way cheaper than the seeds that you buy at the big seed companies. And they have a little personal, my little personal touch on them too. So go over and grab those as well. So let's draw for our second winner. Are you guys ready? Cross your fingers, get the drum roll going, and we're gonna go back into our random comment picker after I unlock my computer. There we go. And let's turn this around here. Max trying to sneak away. He always tries to sneak inside during the live streams. Okay, so let's go ahead and pick another winner. Here we go, guys. Winner number two, scrolling through here. Nancy Lambeth, congratulations, Nancy. You just won a ticket to the Great Grow Along Virtual Garden Festival. Nancy's comment was, thanks for the great video and advice on hardening off plants. I had no clue how to do that. Nancy, I am so happy that you're learning about hardening off, a very important step in making sure that your spring garden is successful is hardening off your vegetables. So I'm glad that you learned and you're gonna have a great garden. I absolutely know it. So make sure that you email me, CallieKim@CallieKimGardenHome.com to claim your ticket and we'll get you all taken care of. Wow, you guys, this is so exciting. I'm excited to see a lot of you at the Great Grow Along. It is gonna be a ton of fun. So let me see here if I can answer a couple questions and then we'll take another question from our YouTube videos over the weekend. Ultimate Gardening, how are you? I'm glad that you're attending the Great Grow Along event. So if you've already grabbed your ticket, pop it here in the chat here. It is gonna be a ton of fun. Glenn Davey, hello. And Glenn says, I have my early lettuces, kale and cilantro in zone 5B Chicago, covered with clear plastic bins, maintaining 40 degrees when nighttime temps are in the 20s. Wow, that's crazy how much those little bins actually protect your seedlings. That's awesome. And in Chicago, oh my gosh, you guys are getting a lot of snow too. So way to go, Glenn. Now he does bring up another point. I forgot to mention the cool weather vegetables can withstand much lower temperatures. So those are definitely ones that you can get planted outdoors before your last frost date. So I'm talking about the vegetables like you might have purchased my Fall Garden Seed Collection that has all cool weather vegetables, peas, lettuce, any type of green pretty much, cool weather herbs like cilantro, like Glenn mentioned, parsley, broccoli, cauliflower. All those are cool weather vegetables that love temperatures under 75 degrees and will even take a frost. But for young seedlings, you do want to protect them with some type of cover just till they get established so you can get those planted out a little bit sooner. So thank you so much, Glenn, for reminding me about that. Great, great suggestion there. Okay, let's go back to our questions from the YouTube videos. And these, I had a couple of questions on composting. So let me just run through those. People love to compost and it's a great way to fertilize your garden for free. So the first question was from Janet Cicada. And Janet says, thank you, Callie Kim, for showing us how easily to compost in a small patio using a 5-gallon container. Is it possible to make a compost in a cardboard box? I have so many problems with fruit flies swarming inside my compost bins and surrounding areas. What would you recommend to make those pests go away? Okay, Janet, I wouldn't recommend necessarily composting in a cardboard box because you're going to be soaking it down with water and then your compost, your cardboard could kind of disintegrate and you could lose your bin actually if it's a cardboard box. But definitely a 5-gallon container is easier or is the way to go. I love the Smart Pots 5-gallon, the Calichem ones that's right over there on the corner. Those work absolutely perfect because they're breathable. So your compost is getting air. You could use a 5-gallon bucket, but I really like the 5-gallon Calichems because, like I said, they're getting air and you can cover them very easily. As far as fruit flies go, once you add materials to your compost, kind of mix it in a little bit. Cover it up, mix it in. That kind of hides it a little bit from the flies. Now, fruit flies aren't necessarily a bad thing for the compost, because they do kind of help break it down, but it can be annoying, especially if it's near your front door. But also make sure that you cover it to keep the heat in, and that might help keep some of the fruit flies away too. So hopefully that will help you out. And guys, if you have compost questions, make sure you go back and watch the entire compost playlist. You can binge it to your heart's delight. There's lots of videos on there on hot composting, the one that Janet mentioned on making compost in a small container. You don't have to have a big space to make compost. So don't let the fact that you have a tiny growing space deter you. You can still make compost in a small space. Let me run through one other quick composting question, then we'll take your questions in the chat. This is from S4. My grass clippings have dandelions, broadleaves, clover, and quack grass. Is it safe to add all of those to my hot compost? I would not want those to come up in my garden. Okay, you can add them to your compost, but you do want to make sure it's a hot compost pile. Make sure that your compost is heating up like I showed on my hot compost video, because that will help kill all of the weed seeds. Because no, you don't want those popping up in your garden. So hot composting for grass clippings. In fact, one of my most watched videos, I think it's got like 2.5 million views or something like that. You can see it on my channel. It's about hot composting with grass clippings. And it worked beautifully. So go back and watch that video if you have questions on that, and hopefully that will help help you get to composting and making that black gold for your garden. Okay, back to the chat now, guys. Answer a couple of questions. The chat is flying by. How much fun this is today to hang out with you guys on a Monday morning. And we do live stream every Monday at noon Pacific time. So if you're brand new at our live stream, welcome. Come back and join us over the weekend for a video, and then come back and join us next Monday. Grab a friend. Spring is coming. We share a ton of great information, and you get to be part of this amazing garden community. Okay, Jack, how are you doing, Jack? Great to see you. Jack is watching from Maryland, so hopefully you're starting to warm up there. And Jack's question is, in my new community garden, the soil is very loose, but doesn't have much organic matter in it. Do I need to add any? It's kind of expensive around here. Okay, Jack, yeah, I totally hear you. It can really add up. And if you're gardening in a brand new space, I would recommend adding some organic material. But you don't have to spend a lot of money to do that. If you can find a source of like leaves, I know it might be hard right now because you're coming off of winter, but leaves, branches, anything you can chop up into small bits. You could get like shredded straw is a great thing to add, and it's fairly inexpensive. If you can find some bagged compost, that's great too. Or there's a lot of landscape companies, landscape supply companies that offer things in bulk. I know in past years, I purchased a whole truckload of compost for about $35. So even if you could maybe split a load with somebody, or if you have access to a truck, you might be able to find some materials for fairly inexpensive. So just look around your area. Maybe you can ask around to friends and neighbors and see what you can do, because Jack, I know how much you love to garden, and where there's a will, there's a way, and how much fun that you get to garden at a community space. It'll be fun to interact with other gardeners and have more space. So yeah, Jack, shredded leaves. Oh my goodness. Spread those out, mow them up with a lawnmower, throw them in a trash can, put a weed whacker in there, and get them nice and small. Make sure you wear your safety glasses though. And you will be good to go. Just mix it in, and you will be amazed at how much the worms come in. They love to eat all that organic matter. Okay, guys, we are gonna draw for our third winner here. Do I wake up my computer? Third winner for a ticket to the Great Grow Along. Are you guys excited? So it would be even, yeah, if any of the winners are here with us today, the little icon that turns around my screen keeps disappearing on me. If any of our winners are here today, oh, here we go. Please let me know, because it would be really fun to kind of celebrate with you if you're here in the chat. So here we go. Time to pick another winner. This is our third winner. Scrolling through, if you see your name and it doesn't land on you, that's always a bummer, but hopefully you'll have a chance next time. Okay, Shawna Crichlow, woohoo, Shawna, congratulations. Shawna learned that hardening off plants is a gradual process. Start off with a couple of hours in a shady area and work your way up until the plant spends the whole day outside. Then they're ready for planting in the garden. So Shawna, congratulations, super exciting. Can't wait to see you over at the Great Grow Along. And make sure you email me your information and we will get you all taken care of with your ticket. Super exciting. Okay, Janella, thank you so much. I love the colors of the flowers in those pots. I am just in love with these. Again, you guys, these are Gerbera daisies and these are perennial in California. They may not survive a really cold, cold winter, but they die back and then I cut them back and they come back every year. So they're a great flower that will be long lasting. For perennials, sometimes you spend a little bit more up front if you're buying transplants, which I wanted to get some immediate pops of color. So that's why I purchased the transplants. Sometimes that's really fun. But then you might spend a little bit more money up front for perennials, but then they last you longer. So it's a really good investment. Okay, yes, chip drop I think is in a lot of different areas. For wood chips, you do wanna make sure that they're high quality wood chips though. I've spread, you know, sometimes they have things in there that might not be that great for your garden. So just maybe ask them if they happen to know what types of wood they're using, or sometimes they might have things in there, you know, that might just be kind of shredded up green waste that might not be super high quality. So just be aware of that, when you're doing the free services like that. So free is good, but you do want to kind of do a little bit of investigation. Okay, yeah, Daniela, Easter-like flowers are the prettiest. Yeah, it's pretty fun, isn't it? Okay, so let's head back and answer another question here from our weekend videos. And our topic number three, I had a lot of questions on this week, was strawberries. So if you guys have never grown strawberries, they are a very easy fruit to grow. They grow great in containers, grow great in ground. And one of my favorite ways is the strawberry crate tower. So I'm gonna pop my camera around there. The strawberries are still kind of waking up. You can see some of them there on the sides. I've got some red mustard greens on the top there, and then strawberries on the, and there's Mac saying hello. And then some strawberries that will be, you know, waking up here as the weather warms up. But anyway, you guys, if you haven't grown strawberries, the crate towers are a great way to grow. And let me just run through some of these questions here. This first question about strawberries is from ET. And the question is, hi Kim, love your channel. I live in Rhode Island, zone 6. What do you suggest I do with these crates in the winter? Will the strawberries come back the following year? And the question to that is, yes, strawberries are perennials. They're very cold hardy in the winter. They go dormant in the winter and they die back. So don't be alarmed if your strawberries look brown and crinkly over the winter time, if you're in a cold climate. They don't grow super fast for me here in California during the winter either. But yeah, you can overwinter them. And what you can do with the crates is you can either bring them inside, pop them in the garage, or you can cover them with like a frost blanket or some type of a, like a quilt. I would probably recommend if you're in a cold area like Rhode Island, you bring them in or put them up next to your house where they're a little bit more protected. If you're growing, and then cover them up. If you're growing them in ground, in a winter area, a cold winter area, you wanna mulch them heavily with leaves or straw. 2 to 3 inches of mulch around the base to protect the little crowns, they're called, that are the roots that are in the ground. But then as soon as the weather warms up, you're going to see beautiful new growth. Now, that being said, the most productive years for strawberries are like the first 3 years, and then it really starts to slow down and you want to replace your plants. So some of mine are really slowing down. I've had them for 3 to 5 years, so I will be replacing several of my towers with new plants this year. But there's tons of information on strawberries on our YouTube channel. We have a whole strawberry playlist with lots of information about fertilizing, about planting the crate towers, how to make the crate towers, how to root the little roots, the runners that come out, so you can get free strawberry plants. So you want to go back and watch that whole strawberry playlist, binge on that too, and you'll know exactly how to grow strawberries. In fact, one of the second questions about strawberries was, how do you fertilize the tower? And I fertilize that just like I would fertilize anything else. I take a watering can, I pop in some worm tea and some good dirt plant food, and then I just slowly water the tower, and then it runs down through the different levels. So my towers, I have the Smart Pots crate liners with in the tower, so they're porous, they have holes in them, and then the water just slowly runs down to the bottom. So it takes a little bit of time because you want to do it slowly so it doesn't all run out the sides, but you definitely want to keep them fertilized probably every couple of weeks so that you get, you know, a lot of strawberries to harvest. Let me see how, I had another question here on strawberries. Oh, some Aunt Alina was asking, will last year's strawberry patch grow back? How can I prune it or prepare it properly so it will grow more strawberries? So all you have to do is just prune off all the dead leaves. Don't prune off the crowns, which is the tiny little part at the base of the berry, and then make sure it's well fertilized every couple of weeks. And yes, they will grow back. For the most part, they will grow back. And then when the weather warms up, you're going to have some beautiful new plants. So go back and watch that strawberry playlist for lots of more information on that. And we got to get moving because we have, I think, two more winners to pick, guys. So let's go and pick another winner for our great grow along. And there's a little look at the strawberry crate tower. Max chilling out in the sun and just having a good old time out here. Okay, so winner number four, ticket number four for the great grow along is Chandrika Tilwalli. So congratulations, Chandrika. This is awesome. And Chandrika's comment is, great info on hardening off. I will see you on Monday live. So hopefully Chandrika is here and is able to see that Chandrika just won a ticket for the Great Grow Along Virtual Garden Festival this weekend. Congratulations. So if you're here, Chandrika, please say hello. And make sure you email me your information, or just email me and I will send you your ticket. So super exciting. You guys, this is gonna be such a great weekend at the Great Grow Along event. And now I wanna head into chat and answer some more of your questions. We have one more winner to pick. We're gonna do that at the end of the live stream. And let me see what questions you have here. Let's see, Melissa Sullivan. Hi, Melissa, how are you? And she's must be answering a question earlier. Kevin of Epic Gardening just showed his watering tool. I saw that as well. That was great on Instagram. That's for watering deep roots. He has a video on his Instagram. That's a great suggestion, Melissa. That would work great for the, for the strawberry crate tower as well. And that's a really handy watering tool. I think that might be fun to try out. So go over and check out Kevin's Instagram at Epic Gardening, and you can see that over there. I actually saw that over the weekend too. Okay, question here from Ashley. I have been having trouble trying to plan out my garden. Should I do square foot gardening? Ashley, that is a great method to garden. There's so many different methods that you can use to plan out your garden. There's some free gardening planning tools online that you might want to check out. So just Google free garden planning tool and some will pop up. I know there's one on Farmer's Almanac. There might be one on gardeners.com still. The square foot gardening method is one of the most popular methods. So if you want to give that a try, I would encourage you to go for it. The most important thing though is just to get started. Don't overthink it. Just get started with something simple. My garden motto, as I share in my book, is start simple, expand later. So I talk about that. I have, you know, a good chapter on that, on how to start simple with maybe just one or two vegetables that you like to eat. Even if you just start with a small container, a little 1 gallon container is perfect. The 5 gallon containers are perfect. Just get started. And there's lots of videos on our, in our spring garden playlist on how you can kind of space out your plants. And also you might want to watch the container garden series from last year and kind of follow what I did as far as spacing out your plants if you're struggling with that. And I also have a lot of information in my book on that as well, on how to plant your garden beds and containers, including spacing. So if you're struggling and you don't have this, I would definitely go ahead and grab this over on my website. You can get a signed copy of this on my website, along with the seeds if you need seeds. So great question. I think a lot of people are struggling with that as well. There's no dumb questions here, so go ahead and ask away. Okay, let's see here if we have any other questions. Oh, Gary. Wow. Hi, Gary. I didn't even realize you're on here. Great to see you. So yeah, start with what you enjoy. If you like lettuce, plant lettuce. If you don't like okra, don't plant okra. So just start with some vegetables that you really enjoy. So Gary, great to see you on here. Thanks for hanging out here with us today. Okay. Let's see. Jack says he does square foot gardening. Very simple. That's wonderful, Jack. It's great to learn what methods have worked. So if any of you have other methods that have worked well for you, then jump on here and share them. And we can all learn from each other. Okay, let's see here. Here's a question from Omar. Hey Omar, how you doing? Hi Callie Kim, good afternoon. I transplanted my seedlings outside without hardening off. If it's okay or they may die. Omar, you definitely do want to harden them off. And I think, don't you live like in Dubai or something like that? I think that's where you live. So what you might want to do, since you already have them in the ground, is you may want to provide them with some type of cover, like some type of shade cloth. Even put up, maybe if you don't have, put some stakes in the ground near them, clip some shade cloth or even like a sheet just to kind of protect them for the first couple of days. And then you can put shade cloth over them, you know, and take it on and off over the next couple of weeks. So definitely do that. But you may want to get some backups going in the house or inside, wherever is easiest for you to start. That way, if something does happen, you'll have some backups in the works just in case. So I always like to have those backups going. Now, that kind of brings me to another question. I had one other question on the weekend video I wanted to bring up. And that was from Andrea Nelson. And we'll get to that fifth winner in just a moment. Very nice explanation of the technique to gradually expose the plants to the outside. My problem is that I don't have any light. I don't have the light inside and the space in my house, but I have a backyard. Do you have any suggestions on how to start seeds outside only? And yes, absolutely. There's a lot of different ways you can do this. You can do it with small little, like if you're living in a cold winter area, you could definitely do it with like small little takeout containers, small little plastic bins, give them some cover at night, or if it's gonna frost during the day or be, you know, crazy weather during the day, but you can definitely get seeds started in the same type of method that I showed you in my seed starting video. You might have a little bit slower type of growth, but you can use those little dome lids like on takeout containers. A lot of people like to do a method called winter sowing. And if you do that and you're here in the chat, please let us know how that's worked for you. And what you do is like cut a milk gallon in half, leave one little part on so the lid is kind of hinged. You can pop your soil in there, pop your seeds in there, make sure you have holes in the bottom. Put the little cover on, that'll help kind of heat things up like a little mini greenhouse. And then as the weather warms up, your little seedlings will be popping out and your lids will pop open and it'll just be a lot of fun. So there's tons of information out there on YouTube, on Pinterest, all kinds of things out there about winter sowing. So do a little bit of research and it absolutely can be done. I mean, grow lights are wonderful. They really help control the environment so you can get things off to a quick start. But if you don't have the space or the budget for that, don't let that stop you. There's definitely ways of doing it. So go for it, you guys. Just get started, whatever you do. And believe me, trust me when I tell you that you're gonna get the bug, you're gonna get hooked, you're gonna be addicted, and you're gonna wanna expand your garden after you start with a few things, learn a few things, eat your first salad. You are not gonna wanna go back. Okay, so here we are, guys, our last winner for a free ticket to the Great Girl Along. Are you guys ready? Nicole, hi. Glad to see you here. Glad that you made it. Even though you're late, no big deal. You can always go back and watch the replay for whatever you missed. Okay, waking up my computer. And we have our last winner here, you guys. This is exciting. What a fun group we've had in the chat. It's always hard when you see your name scroll by. And our fifth winner is Melissa Kingery. Congratulations, Melissa. Melissa's comment is, I have started many vegetables now and have bought a variety of grow lights. Also have learned about hardening off my plants. Starting out with my veggies, with putting my veggies out in the shade. Gonna start for an hour and the next day a couple of hours in the shade. And then the third day an hour in the sun, a couple in the shade and build up gradually. Love learning from Callie Kim. Melissa, you are getting it down, way to go. And that's the way to do it. Just make sure you do that process gradually and you will be good to go with your seedlings. So I'm really glad that a lot of you got a lot out of that video. And we had fun with it too. We had fun shooting it. And a lot of you said you liked the little Hey Siri tip that I gave. Oops, I shouldn't have said that because now my phone's gonna go off. But yeah, I have forgotten so many times and it's always helpful to set reminders. So congratulations, Melissa. Super excited for you and you're gonna absolutely love the Great Grow Along. Congratulations to all the winners, you guys. It has been so much fun. Camera Guy and I really appreciate your participation in the giveaways and we're gonna be doing more this spring. And we have some fun videos planned for this spring. We still have a couple more videos left in the spring garden series. So we're going to be doing how to prepare your garden bed for planting. And then we got to plant all the vegetables that we started from seeds. So we're definitely going to be doing that. I'm also going to be doing some transplanting some lemon and some citrus trees. We're going to be doing that this spring. And we still have a little bit of March left, so we have to fit in our spring garden tour as well. So make sure you stay tuned for that. That will be coming out this weekend, the very first day of spring. I can't believe it's finally spring. So let me answer a couple more questions before we sign off for the day. Appreciate you guys joining us. Amber, new to gardening, love watching your videos. Thank you so much, Amber. Appreciate you hanging out. Rod, I think Rod is here in the chat, and I hope you guys enjoyed as much as I did seeing Rod's tomato plants on our weekend video. We featured him on our weekend video, and I love what he shared. He had positive, encouraging words to say, and his tomatoes and his peppers look amazing. So we actually did have some requests for Rod to come back on, film a little video and show us how he gets his tomatoes, peppers planted and harvest. So yeah, I think Rod, everyone loved your video. So thanks a lot for submitting that to us. We really appreciate it. And we have Sandy watching from Guyana, South America. Wow, welcome Sandy. So glad that you're here. Thanks for taking the time to join us all the way from South America. That's great. Let's see here. Any other questions before we sign off? Here's a question from Barb. This is a great question, Barb. Can I plant raspberries and blueberries in large containers? And yes, you absolutely can. You can pretty much plant anything in containers that you can plant in your in-ground garden, as long as your container is big enough. So for raspberries and blueberries, I would probably go maybe a 10 or 15 gallon, at least that, just to give the roots enough space to grow. Now, that is one thing I love about smart pots, because the fabric is breathable and aerated. You can usually fit a larger plant in a smaller smart pots than if you would use like a hard plastic container, because the roots don't get root bound. They just kind of form this nice fibrous mass. They're able to take up the nutrients and they do very, very well. So hopefully that will help you get some planted. Okay, let's see here. Lots of congrats to the winners. That's wonderful. And let's see if there's any other questions. Omar, thank you so much for your kind words. Thank you, Calikim. I love your videos. They encourage me from Dubai. Okay, I thought you were from Dubai, so that's wonderful. Hello from Palestine, from Samira. That's pretty exciting that you're watching from Palestine. And Powerpuff, can you tell us the soil mix you use? And I believe Cliff just posted that in the chat. It's good dirt. It's amazing soil. I love it. And you can use Calikim 10 to get 10% off. They also do have it in a lot of Target stores. So check your Target store. They usually have smaller size bags, but they sell out really fast. So you might wanna just check online and make sure that your store carries it. Let's see here. Strawberries in laundry baskets from the Dollar Tree. Nicole, I've seen that too. That's pretty cool. Angelica, hello from Germany. Wow, great to have you watching from Germany. And Colleen, can I up pot my seedlings in your seed starting mix? You definitely can, Colleen. You definitely can do that, but you might need a pretty good amount for that. So at that point, you may want to just use some potting mix, just because you have to make so much of that seed starting mix, or add some more cocoa core. And you know, that's one video I actually want to do too, is how to make your own potting mix. So grab some of the good dirt or make your own potting mix. And I can't think of the recipe for potting mix right off the top of my head, but I know we did another live stream where I talked about that, but stay tuned for a video on that as well. So that's actually a really good question. Some people have asked, what if I started my seedlings too early? Like say they're the size of those tomato plants or the cucumber plants and squash plants back there, and it's still not time to get them planted outside. What you can do is you can up pot them or transplant them into a slightly larger container so that you can keep them inside for a little bit longer and the roots don't get root bound. They don't get stunted by being in too small of a container. So up pot them, which means you're just moving them into a bigger size to give them a little bit more time till your weather warms up. So on my spring garden series playlist, I have a video on that, so you know exactly what to do. Very simple. My problem is I run out of space inside and I don't have room to up-pot all those tomato plants, so I harden them off before I up-pot them. While those, I'll probably just get planted right out in the garden because it's getting warm enough here. So hopefully that will help you out. Okay, guys, this has been a ton of fun. Again, congratulations to all the winners. We'll see you guys at the Great Grow Along event this weekend. My presentation will be aired at 8:45 a.m. Pacific time with a live Q&A after. We'll have a spring garden tour, March garden tour coming out on Saturday to celebrate spring, and another live stream next Monday at noon Pacific time. So stay tuned, bring your friend along, and we'll all grow our spring gardens together. All right, guys. Oh yeah, don't forget about the tomato contest. I forgot, Cliff. Cliff's in charge of it. It's over at Gardening Coast to Coast Facebook group, so join that. And we're gonna have a ton of fun. All right, guys, have a great week. We will see you next time. Bye-bye.